have stiffness and free bone, we can push rebound to the stiffness, move it, and have curved rebound instead of the straight one. And the idea was how to find out the curvature of it. So, this is sort of this. Having the straight rebound, we have again this one, doing the stiffness. So then we started with a very simple stuff. We started with these controlling experiments. What actually happens here? We find out that it doesn't matter if it's crystalline materials or polymeric materials. Well, we found out that it's really crucial to have a soft base below the skissors. So we have this sandwich of three items: the skissors, ribbon, and the soft base. If you have the soft base, oops, it doesn't work. It doesn't want to be curved. We found out that this, we don't care much about the friction, and we found out that, well, actually when we try to move with faster speed, it doesn't change the curvature at all. Actually, a lot of preliminary observations we did these days, and okay, we need to find out what actually happens. So the crucial part here, this is your, the crucial part here is that this soft base below this resource below the rhythm. I should claim that it wasn't about really very complicated simulation. We didn't manage to do this console like you now can. So it was a very stupid model. If you have this infinite band, we imagine the rhythm, that's a band, and we load with the point force right below where the resource are. It is pretty narrow, so it can be pointed. Very stupid equation. We can substitute here everything. Everything lies here. So this is elasticity of the base. Actually, the larger it is, the more interesting effect we have here. We can get rid of the solution. It's like an exponential is gonna be with the cosine. And what happens next? If we have the enough load here, we're gonna have this irresistible deformation. So when we move the scissors along the ribbon, the curvature which was below the blade would be fixed when actually the scissors moves away. The radius of curvature is found out by this formula, and we arrive to this expression. We have here geometry, we have here elasticity properties of the ribbon, we have here this softness of the base scale. What actually we need next? We need to go above this threshold of irresistible deformation. It should be enough force, enough load to get this curvature radius be fixed on the ribbon. It's just we need enough strength above this threshold value, and we just modulate the blade with this kind of geometry and we have expression for the minimum load. Actually, the problem is that for the proper paper, which is actually not a very clear material, this is fiber-based and so on, we cannot arrive to the value of the force, but we can arrive for it to the for the aluminium foil, and it looks pretty reasonable, pretty okay estimation. What we did next, we did understand that, well, we cannot use it for the ends. Well, we can treat friction just as some force which try to stretch the ribbon along the ends. So it shouldn't influence the force at all and the deformation at all. So what I loved in this part most, after that we did this young model's measurement, it was really stupid. We did the experiment, changing the load, we were able to change the load, and we were able to change the softness of the base. We just had material, we added the layers of soft material above and above, and having more layers, we had high level of softness of the base. We were measuring the curvature radius, and what I loved here is most that it is really was coolest possible in my life, comparison really between the experiment and theory. Really. The upper paper wasn't good. The office paper was worse than I expected, but we have different materials. We have substitute here the elasticity and geometrical properties. They fit pretty good. And also we found out that when the of the softness values, depending on the layers of the soft material, and also brittle one. So finally, it was a problem like, well, the best problem, standards and so on, but I don't do this comparison with this correlation. It's everything I want to show to you today. Now you understand how people did tasks 4 years ago.